Before we begin, we ask that everyone please silence all phones and other electronic devices for the duration of the ceremony. As a reminder, it is a military tradition that everyone stand for the entrance of the official party during the national anthem and at various other times during formal parts of the ceremony one through. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the entrance of the official party, the singing of the national anthem, followed by the invocation.
If you will, please join me in prayer. Great God, as we gather today to honor Master Sergeant Adrian Cohn, we give you thanks for him and for his 20 years of service to this great nation. We thank you for his faith, his friendship, and his family. And so we ask for a special blessing on them, his wife Maria, daughters Miriam and Naomi, who supported him through it all. And now, Lord, as this time of active duty service to this country draws to a close, we ask your blessings on him. As the scriptures teach, unto whom much is given, much is required. So as he transitioned into the civilian world, help him to continue to be a strong leader and example. We pray also that you bless the rest of this ceremony. I pray this for your glory and our good. Amen.
Thank you, Sergeant Cuevas and Jacqueline Kamen. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. On behalf of the men and women of the 354th Fighter Wing, welcome to today's retirement ceremony honoring Master Sergeant Adrian J. Cohn IV. Today's presiding official from the 354th Medical Support Squadron, Medical Logistics Readiness Flight Commander, First Lieutenant Cody Stanzik. We would like to extend a very special welcome to Master Sergeant Cohn's wife, Maria Cohn, his children, Miriam Wallace and Naomi Cohn, Spock, the most respected half-Vulcan, half-human figure in the United Federation of Planet Starfleet. Spock is known for his distinguished service aboard the USS Enterprise. Finally, we would like to extend a warm welcome to all commanders, chiefs, first sergeants, friends, and family. There is no greater act of citizenship than serving one's country. A career serving one's country is marked by tradition. The transition from civilian to military life, progression through the ranks, changes in duty assignments, and the transition we are here to celebrate today. Thank you in helping us honor Master Sergeant Cohn on the occasion of his retirement after 20 years of faithful service in the United States Air Force.
All right, so first of all, I just want to thank all the family, friends, colleagues, and fellow airmen attending today as we honor Master Sergeant Adrian Coe for his 20 years of service to the United States Air Force and to our country. Maria, Miriam, Naomi, thank you for your unconditional support throughout Master Sergeant Coe's career. Without your support, none of this would be possible today. So we're here, as we all know, to honor Master Sergeant Coe. And I'm sure a lot of you know quite a bit about Master Sergeant Coe, but I'm betting not a lot of you know too much about Adrian. So I want to spend just a minute telling you a little bit about Adrian. So Adrian J. Coe IV was born on May 2nd, 1969 in New Orleans, Louisiana, to Edwina and Adrian J. Coe III. His mother was primarily a homemaker, and his father was a GS-13 engineer with the Army Corps of Engineers working in the flood prevention program. Adrian spent about half of his childhood growing up in D.C. before returning back to Louisiana. In 1988, he moved to Steubenville, Ohio to attend Franciscan University of Steubenville, where he received his Bachelor of Arts degree in theology. In 1990, Adrian met his future wife, Maria, and 4 short years later, they began dating before marrying in 1996, just before Adrian entered the Air Force. So when I asked Adrian why he decided to join the Air Force, he simply stated it was a way to get the heck out of Steubenville, Ohio. On top of that, he also stated that he wanted to do interesting work and be a part of an organization that truly cares for its people. So Adrian met with a recruiter. He rocked the ASVAB and basically was handed a book of AFSCs and told to choose any AFSC that he wants. So in that situation, he done what any of us probably would have done, you know, the smart thing. And he picked the AFSC with the shortest tech school that he had in order to not be away from Maria for so long. So in 1997, Adrian and Maria welcomed their first child, Miriam. He was now married, expecting her very own child. And later down the road in 2000, they welcomed their second child, Naomi, who is with us today and now attending the University of Fairbanks, Alaska, where she is studying culinary arts. So that's a little bit of backstory on Adrian. Now let's talk about Master Sergeant Coe and his 2-decade Air Force career that spans 20 assignments, 5 states, 3 countries, and 2 deployments. So looking back at Master Sergeant Coe's career, reviewing his EPRs, his decorations, and thinking back to the last 2+ years that I've known him, I noticed a few key themes that were consistently repeated about Master Sergeant Coe, assignment after assignment, and supervisor after supervisor. The first theme is dedication. You don't spend 20 years, or nearly half of your life up to this point, serving the same organization unless you're truly dedicated. Dedicated to your work, dedicated to the people you serve with, and dedicated to the mission. EPR after EPR, they all said the same thing about Master Sergeant Coe. He has an unending drive for success. He's always willing to accept more responsibilities, and he never lets anything stand in the way of completing any task that stands before him. The second theme is giving. Winston Churchill once said, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give." Throughout Master Sergeant Coe's career, he has embodied our second core value, service before self. He has served as a lector for his church. He's tutored airmen in order to help them pass their college classes. He's assisted with home repairs in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. He's served as a squadron tax representative in order to assist airmen filing their taxes. He's translated foreign service agreements into English so more people could understand them. He's mentored airmen who have failed their CDCs and afterwards were able to turn around and pass with flying colors. And it goes on and on and on about the same type of things, but I think we only have the room for another 30 minutes, so I'm going to press right on through. But the big takeaway is that Master Sergeant Coe is the person who will always put other people's needs before his own and do whatever he can to help everyone else succeed. The last theme I noticed was knowledgeable. I don't think there's a more intelligent or knowledgeable person in this room when it comes to a lot of things. but especially when it comes to computers. I have a degree in computer information systems. I can fix a lot of my own problems when it comes to IT, but Master Sergeant Combs' ability to troubleshoot and fix pretty much any computer-related problem makes me feel like I've never touched a computer in my life, and I need to go back and ask for a refund at the university. All the while, he's using nothing but hotkeys, never touching the mouse, so I have zero clue what he's doing. But really, you can't go into any section in this clinic and find, or you can't go into any section in this clinic and not find some sort of database or spreadsheet or some computer system that Sergeant Combs didn't create or modify in some way to make it easier for the end user. But his knowledge goes extends well beyond just his computer capabilities. So as we know, he enlisted while already having a bachelor's degree. He completed not one, but two CCAF degrees. And he even began courses towards his master's degree. The best part is that he's used his wealth of knowledge to make each section that he's ever been assigned to a better place than when he entered it. A little fun fact about Master Sergeant Combs. So thanks to a deployment to Iraq in, with the Army back in 2007, where he served on the Redistribution Property Assistance Team, Master Sergeant Combs may be very well the only 4AO who knows how and has also driven an M1 Abrams tank along with several other combat vehicles. So I'm not really sure where that ties into Health Administration, but damn, it sounds really cool. So while I was prepping for Sergeant Combs' retirement, I reached out to some of his old supervisors to see if they had any juicy dirt they can give me on him so it can make us a little bit more lively. Besides the time when Master Sergeant Combs got called out by an inspector for having a dirty refrigerator, I guess, next to his desk, one response stood out that I would like to share with everyone. Major Philip Pope, who was stationed at the 354th Medical Group as the TOPA and Systems Flight Commander, wrote, "Master Sergeant Combs has the humility to admit to being wrong. The intelligence